Hi everyone, welcome to lesson 5 in our series 3D modeling for newbies. In this lesson, we'll take a look at the Extrude and Weave tool, probably the most versatile of all the 3D modeling tools within the Vectric software. We need to take care of some business first. If you're looking to use the tool, click on the third icon on the top row. How we use this tool is by drawing some vectors and some profiles. So we select our vector, we say that's the rail we're going to use, not unlike the two rail sweep, except it's a single rail, and our profile. And there we have our shape. Let's try this again. We're going to delete this component. And now we're going to select several vectors. Those are the rails we use. This is the profile we're going to choose. We're going to apply it to those rails. And we hit apply. There's the components, quick and easy. There's several different options within this tool. So what if we choose all 6 vectors? Those are the vectors we choose for our rails. This is the shape we want to use. We click apply. And you can see the extra symbol that was added to show where the profile was going to be applied. Let's try it one more time. We're going to use those as the rail. We're going to use a different profile. Different end result. So you're starting to see it could become an endless possibility. We have a single rail. The triangular shape is added to the top. We can then choose our second shape and apply it to the bottom. And there's a nice transition from the triangular profile to the rounded profile. Let's try all 6 vectors. We click on our triangular profile, apply it to the vectors, and you can see the longer symbol represents the triangular. We now click on our second shape and apply it where we want. There's a nice design using both triangular and rounded shapes. We're going to choose all 6 vectors again. We're going to apply our triangular shape to the top and our rounded shape to the bottom of selected ones. So there's a transition from triangle to round. We hit apply. The possibilities become endless. So let's try this one more time. We're going to select just the 2 vectors, one horizontal and one vertical, and now we're going to choose the option of weave over and under. And this will take one vector and put it underneath or over the next vector. You can adjust how much it goes under and how much it goes over, creating an interesting basket weave. Let's try this again with all 6 vectors and the shapes. We choose the over and under. We can adjust the shape height, basically, how much it rises above the corresponding component. And we adjust to our needs. We Again, choosing all the vectors. Applying our first profile, and then our second profile. I can say with certainty that endless hours have been used coming up with new and different textures with this tool. But there are a few things that are important to understand about this tool. For example, we choose all of the circles, a simple half circle as the profile, and the end result wasn't exactly what I expected. I thought they were going to weave in and out. But please note that the vectors touch one another. They don't actually overlap one another. So the end result is not a weave at all. I'm going to take our outer circles and move them in slightly, so there is a slight overlap. We select them all. Choose our profile again. This is without the weave. And now we apply the weave to that same design, and you can see indeed the fact that the vectors do overlap. They do weave in and out of each other. I'm going to try this one more time. We're going to move the circles in even further. The first three on the right, move them in a little bit more. The three on the left, move them in a little bit more. And the same with the top and bottom row of circles. Now there's a significant overlap. We choose all of our circles, click on the icon, choose our profile, hit apply. Again, interesting shapes can be had with this tool. So let's take a look within the software, possible uses of this tool for the clip art. Click on the rope and the rope link itself. Here's the process of creating that rope clip art. I'm going to adjust the size of the link just a little bit extra. I'm going to draw a circle to the size and shape that I want. Choose my Extrude and Weave. And the circle will be my rail. But instead of a profile vector shape to create a component, I'm going to actually choose the rope link component. And the software will take that rope link and place it around the vector that you've chosen. You can adjust the shape height or the base height, much like we learned in lesson one. And that's how that rope border was created. If you notice, the original rope goes counterclockwise. My rope link goes clockwise. So you have the option now of creating direction with your rope twist. Let's try a different option. I create some undulating vectors, select those as my rails. I want to use the rope link component to be placed along the undulating vectors. And now we have an interesting border, an interesting shape, an interesting component that could be used in many different designs. I'm going to bring in another clip art from the software, the anchor. Adjust the height. And as we learned in lesson one, the component properties is important. We're going to change the anchor property to merge. And we're going to adjust the base height so it sits above the rope. Now we have the beginnings of what might be made into a plaque, simply by using the Extrude and Weave and importing other components from the software or from another place. So be creative. Try out new things. I hope this gave you a little insight into the Extrude and Weave. We're going to continue this in Lesson 6. If you'd like to learn more about the software and what could be done with it, subscribe. Make sure you click on the little bell so you're sent a notice of when I publish new videos. And if you have a question, send me an email, mm@mezalick.com. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Enjoy.